والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. الحمد لله نحمده ونشكره ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وصلواته وسلامه على رسول الله وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد، فيا عباد الله ويا معشر المسلمين، الله سبحانه وتعالى يقول: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. من حكم النبوية أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال في حديث يرويه زياد بن لبيد ويقول: لقد ذكر رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم شيئا فقال: إن ذلك عند أوان ذهب العلم. فقلت: يا رسول الله، وكيف يذهب العلم إذا كنا نقرأ القرآن ونقرئه أبناءنا؟ ثكلتك أمك زياد، إني كنت راك من أفقه رجل بالمدينة، أوليس هذه اليهود والنصارى يقرؤون التوراة والإنجيل ولا يعملون بشيء مما هما؟ In this hadith that's related in the Musnad of Imam Ahmad and Ibn Majah رضي الله عنهما, that Labid, Ziyad ibn Labid, one of the great Sahaba, was with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned something, and then he said, but that won't come until knowledge is gone from the people, or knowledge is gone during that time. And Ziyad asked him a question. He said, how will knowledge go, ya Rasulullah, if we read the Quran, the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we teach it to our children, and our children teach it to their children, until the end of time, until the Yawm al-Qiyamah? And so the Prophet ﷺ said, may your mother weep over you, Ziyad. May your mother weep over you. I was thinking that you were of the most understanding of the people of Medina, about this deen, about Islam. And then he said, don't you see these Jews and these Christians? They read their Torah and they read their Injil, but they don't act according to anything in it. And so what this hadith is an indication about the nature of huda, about the nature of guidance, that it is not simply enough that the guidance is there, but it needs to be implemented. Now if you look at us as a body, the mu'minun, the muslimun, the people of Islam, the deen of Islam, we are almost seeing the time when Sayyidina Ali in a hadith relates that the Prophet ﷺ said, يُوشِكُ أَنْ يَأْتِيَ عَلَى النَّاسِ زَمَانٌ لَا يَبْقَى مِنَ الْإِسْلَامِ إِلَّا إِسْمُهُ وَلَا يَبْقَى مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ إِلَّا رَسْمُهُ مَسَاجِدُهُمْ عَامِرَةٌ وَهِيَ خَرَابٌ مِنَ الْهُدَى. That there's coming a time over the humanity when nothing will remain of this deen of Islam except its name. Somebody will call themselves Muslim, that's going back, they're relating themselves to the deen of Islam, because Muslim is the one who's in a state of Islam to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a state of submission. And then he said, and there won't remain anything of the Qur'an except its letters, the rasm, the outward form of the Qur'an. And he said the masajid would be filled, full. Masajidhum amiratun, would be full. وَهِيَ خَرَابٌ مِنَ الْهُدَى. It is bereft of huda. Because huda is not the rasam. It's the meanings, the actions that the rasam, the outward form indicates. And if that does not exist, then in reality, Islam is only a form with no reality, with no meaning. Somebody asked Hassan al-Basri about Islam and he said, المسلمون في قبورهم والإسلام في كتبي. That the Muslims are in their graves and Islam is in books. So the indication is already with the Tabi'een were complaining that the Sahaba were gone. And then the Tabi'een complained that the Tabi'een were gone. Imam Malik radiallahu anhu said, أدركت قوما كان يقولون ذهب الناس. I knew a people and he met the Tabi'een, they used to say, the people are gone, there's no more people. So it's an indication that the nature of this teaching is each generation is more watered down than the one before it. But despite that, the Prophet ﷺ said, أُمَّتِي كَمَطَرْ My ummah is like rain. لَا يُدْرَى أَوَّلَهُ خَيْرٌ أَمْ آخِرِي We don't know whether the beginning of it has the best or the last of this ummah has the best. So this is an indication from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself, and he said, "Al-khayru fiyya wa fi ummati ila an taqum as-sa'a." That goodness and virtue is in my people until the last hour is called. Now, if you look at what the sickness of the Muslims is, that we hear the guidance and then we don't act on it. We hear the guidance and we don't act on it. And this is the reason that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Al-Fatiha says, then we ask for guidance, غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. Not those who have the wrath, غضب incurred upon them. Why? Because they hear the guidance and they don't follow it. Nor those who are ضالين, that they have no guidance in the first place. The مغضوب عليهم are in a worse state. They hear the guidance and they don't respond to it. Now, the reason that the response doesn't take place is very clear. It is because the heart is dead. If there is not a living heart, then there's nothing to respond. Because just as the heart of the body is what gives the body life, the spiritual heart is what gives the ruh life. It's what animates the essence of the human being to act towards virtue, to act towards those things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has called them to. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Qur'an, إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ لَيَدْعُونَ الَّتِي هِيَ أَقْوَمْ This book calls to the most virtuous things, to the most straight things. It's a book that has no iwaj in it, no crookedness. It's a book that guides to the sirat al-mustaqim, to the straight path. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, أَسْتَجِيبُوا Call, return, answer this call. Quran brings to life and jihad, mujahada, struggling fi sabilillah. That those, because life by its nature is struggle. Depression, I have anxiety. And the Prophet ﷺ said, let me teach you some words. If you say these things, that the hair rider has hold of that, then he has control of his horse. And it's also the crown of the horse. It's where the beauty of the horse lies. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala possesses us in that place where we have no ability to get out of that grasp. The grasp of Allah. The qabda of this nasiyah. Nasiyati biyadika. And this is what Hud alayhi salam told, and your Lord. You see, Hud is calling the people to hidayah, to guidance, and he says, he's my Lord and he's your Lord. Because in reality, it doesn't matter if people reject the truth. Truth is as it is. It never changes. Objective truth does not change. For centuries, human beings believed that the earth was flat. That did not change the reality of the earth, one iota. It didn't change the measurements, it didn't change anything about the earth. The earth was as it was and is as it was. This is the reality. So those people that were thinking something, it was only the delusion in their own mind. As for truth, it's truth whether we accept it or not. So he said, Hud said alayhi salam that he Rabbi wa Rabbikum, he is my Lord and your Lord. Ma min dabbatin, there is no animal, there's no creature, there's no dabba, there's no creature, illa huwa akhidun bi nasiyatiha, except that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has it firmly in the nasiya, is holding its forelock. Firmly. In other words, everything is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything is in the control of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. نَاصِيَةِ بِيَدِكَ مَاضٍ فِيَ حُكْمُكَ Your hukum. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has two hukum. He has what is called the hukum al-shar'i, which is what He has given taklif of this ummah. He has told this ummah and the whole of humanity that they have to be within the hukum, the judgment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in what concerns our transactions between Allah and between the slaves of Allah, the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the hukum of Allah, which is called the hukum al-shar'i. And this, the human being has the ability to break this hukum, to go outside of the hukum, to become fasiq, to become somebody that breaks out of this shell that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded him to be in. The other hukum is called al-hukum al-kawni, or al-hukum al-qadri, which is the hukum of the qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and no one, and no creature, no created thing can break out of this hukum. Human beings cannot fly. They can create machines that make them fly, but it's still based on these sunan, these laws, these ahkam of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has created and He has forced us to remain within. We cannot break these laws. So He says, مَاذِن فِيَ حُكْمُكَ. This hukum of yours is fulfilling itself in me. I cannot escape this hukum, both the shar'i and the kawni. The shar'i because I'm your abd, inni abduka bi'i'tiraf. I'm recognizing that I'm your slave. And this is a way of drawing near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhana lidha asra bi'abdihi. When He called him His slave, this is a tashreef from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibadur Rahman. This is tashreef from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibadullah. Walamma qama abdullahi. This is tashreef from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All of the other creation are عَبِيدٌ لِلَّهِ. In the same way that we say الدَّارُ لِلَّهِ, the house is belongs to Allah in reality. Or we say all of these other, everything in creation belongs to Allah. But when we say نَاقَةُ اللَّهِ, this is تَشْرِيف from Allah for this camel, the camel of Allah. When we say بَيْتُ اللَّهِ الْحَرَمُ, the haram of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is تَشْرِيف from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And He gave this ummah تَشْرِيف by calling them His slaves, عِبَادُ الرَّحْمَنِ الَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْنًا. Those people who walk, tread lightly upon the earth. These are the slaves that Allah has given them sharaf in this dunya. He's given them honor and they will be honored in the next world. And so this is a recognition of that before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنِّي عَبْدُكَ. I am your slave. نَاصِيَةِ بِيَدِكَ. مَاذِن فِيَ حُكْمُكَ. عَدْلٌ فِيَ قَضَاؤُكَ. Your qada is adl. When Allah makes a hukum, the tanfeed or the implementation of that hukum is called qada. When Allah brings that hukum about into existence, in reality, it never was other than that in the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because there's no past, present or future in the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But from our limited perspective, when it comes into existence through our own actions, we say, عَدْرٌ فِيَّ قَضَاءُكَ. Your qada is adl. In other words, it's just. Now look at Hud alayhi salam, when he said, إِلَّا هُوَ أَخْدٌ بِنَاصِيَتِي. That he's taking it by its hand, نَاصِيَتِيَا. Then he said, وَإِنَّ رَبِّي. إِنَّ رَبِّي عَلَى صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. My Lord is on a صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ, is on a straight path. This straight path is the path of عَدَل. It's the path of justice, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is just in His qawl, in His word, in His amal, in His speech, in His hukum, in His judgment, in His qada, in the implementation of that justice, in His nahi, in what He forbids us to do, in His amr, in what He commands us to do. All of these things Allah is just in. His nahi, He's just in it because it's mafsada for His slaves. There is some foul thing in that thing that Allah has forbidden for His slaves. He's just in His thing that He commands us to because there's only benefit, there's maslaha in what He commands. Nothing that He has commanded does not have maslaha, because that is the maqsad, that is the purpose of His commands, are the maslaha. Just as the purpose of His prohibitions or are because of the mafsada, of those things that are dangerous for the human being. And like that, His thawab, the thawab of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is with adl. Because He gives whoever He wants. By their actions, He forgives them. So His tawab is with adl, bi fadlihi wa rahmatihi. By His overwhelming bounty and His by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa iqabuhu, and the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is bi mahdi adrihi. It's with the absolute justice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so this is a recognition of that. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, inni as'aluka bi kulli ismin huwa laka. I ask you by every name that is yours. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded His slaves, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمِنُوا وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَابْتَغُوا إِلَيْهِ الْوَسِيلَةِ. And seek the means to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Seek the means to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَجَاهِدُوا فِي سَبِيلِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. And struggle in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that perhaps you might be people of success, people of harvest in the akhirah. And so if you look at this, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling us to ask by the names of Allah. This is the greatest wasila to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because it's by His names. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like one of them said, he said, somebody said to him, you have so little zad to take to the akhirah. You have so little zad. And he said, هَلْ يَجُرَّ الْعَبْدُ زَادَهُ إِلَى بَيْتِ كَرِيمٍ. Does the slave take his own provision to the house of the generous one? Does the slave take his own provision to the house of the generous one? No one will enter Jannah except by the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Allah has commanded us to seek the means to Allah. The first means is the tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through His names. Through the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the first means to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To call on Allah mukhlisan lahu deen. That the deen, the daynuna is lillah. That we are only in submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no other deen but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's deen between the mu'min and his Lord. He brings no other rules in. And so this is the wasila to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is through the tawheed of Allah. And then through his own actions, through the actions of the slave, through those actions that he asked, Ya Allah, I gave this sadaqah on that day, like the three men in the cave, when the rock fell upon them and each asked by some action they did, and that is how the rock came free. So this is the wasila to Allah, but his names, إِنِّي أَسْأَلُكَ بِكُلِّ إِسْمٍ by every name that is for you. By every name that is for you. And then he says, that I ask you by every name, بِكُلِّ اسْمٍ هُوَ لَكَ سَمَّيْتَ بِهِ نَفْسَكَ, that you have called yourself by that name. Al-Qahir, Al-Jabbar, Al-Hakam, Al-Adil, Al-Rahman, Al-Rahim. All of the beautiful names. وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءِ الْحُسْنَى. Allah has the beautiful name. So he told his slaves to call him by those names. Call the Rahman, ad'u al-Rahman, ad'u Allah or ad'u al-Rahman, call Allah or call on the Rahman. All the names of Allah are beautiful to call upon Him. The Qadi Abu Bakr in the Ahkam al-Qur'an has noted 148 names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Qur'an alone. The names of Allah, no one knows them except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The actual names that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ لِلَّهِ تَسْعَةً وَتَسْعِينَ إِسْمًا مَنْ أَحْصَاهَا دَخَلَ الْجَنَّةِ. Those are 99 names that if the slave has acquired them through knowledge of them, and calling on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, دخل الجنة. He will enter Jannah. Those are the 99 names. But Allah only knows how many names that He has. No one else. So He said that you have revealed in your own book, أو علمته أحد من خلقك, or you taught somebody from your creation. One of your creation. One man in the presence of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Sahih Muslim, he was sick and he was calling. This is called Anin al-Marad. When he calls on this name, Anna yinnu. And then the man said, Kuf anka hadha. Stop doing that. It was bothering one of the Sahaba, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, leave him, because he's calling on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is a name of Allah. When the animal is in the state of misery and calling, he's calling on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When anybody that's suffering, when they call, that is the name they're calling on. And that's one of Allah's names that we don't know. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told him to know that is a name of Allah. The Anin al-Marid, calling on the sickness of the Marid when he called. And so then he said, "Oh, استأثرت به في علم الغيب عندك," or even those names that you have kept hidden in your own unseen knowledge that you haven't revealed to anyone. I'm asking you by those names. So he's asking by all of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he said, "أن تجعل القرآن العظيم ربيع قلبي." Make that you make. This is the most powerful du'a because it's on all the names of Allah, and one of them is His ism Allah al-A'zam, the greatest name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That if somebody asks him by this name, he doesn't turn it away. This is the greatest name of Allah, and it's encompassed in those names because you're asking by every name. He said, "أن تجعل القرآن العظيم ربيع قلبي." Make the Quran al-Azim, this vast Quran, make it the rain that brings my heart to life. Make it the rain that brings my heart to life, because the hearts are dead without Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's rain. And His rain is the unseen meanings of His words that enter into the heart of the mu'min, and He yansharah, He has inshirah of the sadr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that He has expanded the breast. وَمَنْ شَرَحَ صَدْرَهُ لِلْإِسْلَامِ, that He expanded the breast of Islam so this light can be encompassed in the narrow breast of the human being. Without that light, his breast is ضَيِّق, حَرَج, is full of of narrowness and inability to accept. That's why he wants retribution from his fellow brothers and sisters. That's why he's miserly. That's why he's covetousness. That's why he has his shahwa. All of these things because his breast is constricted. The light hasn't entered into it. And so he said, تَجْعَلَ الْقُرْآنَ الْعَظِيمِ رَبِيعَ قَلْبِ. Make it the rain of my heart. Make it the spring rain that brings the heart back to life after it was dead. And this is the power of the Qur'an, to bring a dead slave back to life. وَمَنْ كَانَ مَيِّتًا فَأَحْيَيْنَاهُ. The one that was dead. And we brought him to life with what? With the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when it enters into the heart. وَجَعَلْنَا لَهُ نُورًا. And we gave him that light, because rain, by the nature of rain, brings things back to life. And life is from the rain and the sun. So with the rain comes the sun to fulfill the completion of that circle of life. So the heart comes to life from the rain of Allah, and then that light enters into it and nourishes it. And this is the way plants grow, by the rain and then by the photosynthesis from the light. These are all mithal, analogies that Allah has given His slaves in creation to reflect upon. And so this light comes into the heart. وَجَعَلْنَا لَهُ نُورًا يَمْشِي بِهِ فِي النَّاسِ. He walks with it amongst humanity. He walks with it. So no one can lead him astray. Because he's عَلَى صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. Because his Lord is on a straight path, and the gift that he sent down. Look at this book of Allah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls it تَنْزِيل. That it's a revelation. If you look at the word revelation, نَزَلَ. That this Qur'an was أُنْزِلَ عَلَى مُحَمَّدٍ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. It came down on our Sayyid Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this nazar is nuzul in the Arabic language, is the gift that you present to the guests. It's the gift that you present to the guests. We are the guests of Allah in this earth. We are the guests of Allah. We have a short period in this house. This is the abode that Allah has given us. And then we have to have the adab of the guests. And the gift that He has given us, the gift that He has brought forward in this house, in this abode of our earthly life, is the Qur'an. Ma'dubatullah. The Qur'an, according to the Prophet, is the ma'dubatullah. It is the banquet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And He calls us to His banquet. He calls us and says, استجيبوا. Answer this call, the banquet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what nazala means in the Arabic language. To alight as a guest upon people. To come down as a guest, to descend upon people so that you can what? تُكْرَمْ مَنْ كَانَ يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ فَلْيُكْرِمْ ضَيْفًا. Hasn't Allah shown us His ikram, His generosity? And so He asks us, show generosity to the guest He has sent to us, which is His book. أَنْ تَجْعَلَ الْقُرْآنَ الْعَظِيمَ رَبِيعَ قَلْبِي وَالنُّورَ صَدْرِي. Once the rain comes, the light enters and expands the heart. And like oxygen comes into the lungs and spreads all over the body and nourishes the body itself. By first it comes into the lungs and then it goes into the heart. So this inshirah, this expansion comes into the breast, enters into the heart, and the heart pumps it all through all every cell of the body. And this is the meaning of this light that comes into the heart. وَنُورَ صَدْرِ وَجَلَاءَ حُزْنِي. And the jala of huzn, and the thing that dispels grief and anxiety. Huzn is that thing that happened in the past. So your past, all those bad things that have happened, you let it go. You let it behind. You put it behind yourself. Allahu Akbar. Just put it behind yourself, because Allah is greater than all of that. And we're asking Allah for His tawbah. We're asking Allah for ihya al-qulub, to bring the hearts back to life. In the Qur'an, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَلْهَاكُمُ التَّكَاثُرُ. You have become occupied, preoccupied with gathering wealth. أَلْهَاكُمُ التَّكَاثُرُ. لَهُ is the word that Allah uses here. Lahu is entertainment. It's diversion. It's this temporary pleasure that gives the soul some temporary satisfaction, but when it's gone, they feel the emptiness again. It is to the heart what playing is to the limbs. Lahu lilqalb lil'ab liljawarih. It's the same thing as lu'ab is to the limbs when you go out and play sports or play some game. That is lahu to the heart. And this is not a game. Life is not a game. So Allah says, free your hearts from other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The way to do that is to go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with tawbah. And the way of tawbah, His path is through the book of Allah. So He says, dispel it, make it the dispeller of my huzn, because huzn. And then He says, وَذَهَابَ هَمِّي وَغَمِّي. Ham is anxiety about the future. Ham is anxiety created by things existing at that time. So in other words, Everything is dispelled from past, present, and future by the book of Allah. When one enters into the basat of Allah in His book, the covered place that He has laid down for His slaves, then all of existence is dispelled. It doesn't have the meaning that it had before. أَلْهَاكُمُ التَّكَاثُرُ حَتَّى زُرْتُمُ الْمَقَابِرُ Until you come to your graves. In Sahih Muslim, the Prophet said, عُدُّ أَنفُسُكُمْ مِنْ أَصْحَابِ الْقُبُورِ Be like people already in the grave. Don't be people that are diverted in this world. Don't be people of lahu in this world. Be people that are with Allah and they're diverted on other than Allah by the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and implementation of His words, of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so this is those things. أَلَا إِنَّ أُولِيَا اللَّهِ لَا خَوْضٌ عَلَيْهُمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ They have neither khawf, which is fear of the future, nor huzn, which is the grief from the past. Those are the people that have entered into the wilayah of Allah. وَاللَّهُ وَلِيُّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا Allah is the wali of those who believe. So we have to turn back to Allah and don't ever think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not have the qudra or power to change your state, to turn the heart upside down. That is the nature of the heart. يَا مُقَلِّبَ الْقُلُوبِ ثَبِّتْ قَلْبِي عَلَى دِينِكَ Turner over of the hearts, make firm my heart on your deen. This is what Allah is telling us. To ask Him, to turn to Him. Now look at shakwa. I will finish this now. The shakwa, if the maratib shakwa, there are degrees of complaining to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the Qur'an we know, أَبُثُ شَكْوَاهِ إِلَى اللَّهِ That the anbiya, they say, I complain to Allah alone. I complain to Allah. The Muslim now, we complain to everybody but Allah. We're busy writing letters to this congressman, that congressman. We're busy going to the doctor. We're busy doing this. Everything other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Where are the Muslims that are complaining to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Because He's the one that hears the complaint. Now, the reason is, Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyyah rahimahullah says, that the reason that the one who knows Allah complains only to Allah is because he knows where the complaint came from. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, that وَمَا أَصَابَ مِنْ مُصِيبَةٍ فَبِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِ النَّاسِ Anything that afflicts you is by what your own hands have earned. Anything that afflicts you is by what your own hands have earned. So this is what's called تَصْلِيطُ مُوجِبَةِ أَنفُسِنَا The تَصْلِيط that Allah has subjugated us to enemies, our enemies, بِمُوجِبَةِ أَنفُسِنَا By what our own selves have brought about. By what our own selves have brought about. So the one who knows Allah turns to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and says, Ya Allah, ashtaki, ashku ilayka nafsi. I'm complaining about my own self. My heart is dead. Bring my heart back to life. I'm distant from you. I'm in a state of ma'asih. I'm in a state of ghafla, of heedlessness, of disobedience. Bring my heart back to life. أن تجعل القرآن العظيم ربيع قلبي يا الله بكل اسم هو لك By every name I'm calling on you but it has to be from our hearts if it's not from the heart it's just words on the tongue خفيف على اللسان just light on the tongue it has to be from the heart and then Allah answers those who call the مضطر the one that is in a state of اضطرار is in a state he has no other place to turn but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so they say that the one who complains to the slave إن شكوت لابن إلى ابن آدم إنما تشكو الرحيم إلى من لا يرحمه. If you complain to those sons of the of children of Adam, you're complaining about the Rahim, about Allah, to the one who will have no rahma for you. He won't have rahma for you. Don't expect rahma from the slaves of Allah. Expect rahma from the source of rahma, which is Ar Rahman, Ar Rahim. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله الطيبين وعلى صحابه وعلى من والاه اللهم ردنا إلى الإسلام إلى دينك ردا جميلا يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم ردنا إلى الإسلام ردا جميلا يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم لا تسلط بذنوبنا من لا يرحمك ومن لا يرحمنا ولا يخافك فينا يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم لا تسلط بذنوبنا لا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يرحمنا ولا يخافك فينا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم إنا عبادك يا أرحم الراحمين، نسألك لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك باسمك العظم يا أرحم الراحمين أن تغفر لنا وترحمنا وتحيي قلوبنا. اللهم وحد بين صفوفنا، اللهم ألف بين قلوبنا، اللهم ثبت أقدامنا، اللهم أحفظ أولادنا، اللهم أحفظ أهالينا، اللهم أحفظ أزواجنا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم توعافينا يا أرحم الراحمين، أنت المعافي، لا عافية إلا عافيتك يا أرحم الراحمين. فعافينا في ديننا وفي دنيانا وفي أبداننا وفي أسماعنا وأبصارنا وقوتنا أبدا ما أحييتنا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم أحيي قلوبنا.